Story. This is a film, an actual film, 35mm. We got it from the archives. We're playing it tonight in the opening night of our Quentin Tarantino film retrospective. But this is it. It's just arrived from our distributor. You can see here it's got the title on it. Wild Hunde, Reservoir Dogs. Obviously it's the German title as well as the English title. So, a 35mm film, when it's delivered, comes in different smaller spools, as they call it, mini reels. Inside these film canisters, we have 35mm print. So that's the first spool there. It looks like we have six different spools. They're going to make up the entire film. We're going to wind these all together onto a much larger spool. If you can see this here on the projector, I can understand that. It's pretty much saying spool number one. So this is my first spool. Let's take a look at it. I'm trying to figure out from exactly when this is from. There's no information really about the date of this print, but it could have been reprinted at any stage. Sometimes they reprint some of the more famous films. So every spool comes with some film at the beginning of it. It doesn't have any picture on it. It's pretty much just some information telling the projectionist what spool number it is. So every time you get a spool, you've got to unwind it. You're pretty much winding back until you can find the first frame of the film. This is all pretty much a scrap film. So basically what we're doing, we're moving everything from the individual spools and we're putting it onto one really big spool. This spool is then going to play on the top of this tower. It's going to come around here. And we're going to thread it through the machine here. You can see the different sprockets, the different the gates and everything. The film's going to go through here. This is the lens. It's going to shine into the cinema. You see down here the curtains are closed. We have all sorts of sound and everything. This is a whole bunch of chaos, basically. Okay, so this is the beginning of the first spool. I'm going to wind it straight up to the larger spool. My first frames here. I don't think the camera is going to be able to pick up on that very well, but we can see that's the opening frame. It says it looks like some sort of distributor logo. Okay, the second frame I see is some sort of award. It looks like the Cannes Film Festival logo. Cannes Film Festival 1992, I believe I can read. Official selection. Perhaps, I don't know how old this print is, but perhaps it was the actual print that was played here in Europe at Cannes Film Festival. That'd be something special. So basically what's happening, this smaller spool is going to get wound over here to the larger spool. It takes about 45 minutes to get the whole thing together, a little bit shorter if you know what you're doing. We're going to wind up over here. By the end of this, the entire reel is going to be filled with film. Because this is the first spool, and that's the beginning of the spool, it means the beginning of the movie is going to be at the end of the movie. So I'm going to have to rewind this movie once I put it all together.
So we can go much faster than this. I haven't gone much faster yet. The fastest you can go, you need a break once it finishes. And Babylon here have this lovely break. It's basically a sponge. A sponge wrapped up in an old t-shirt. I know it's an old t-shirt because this is the same break that I used when I used to work here 4 years ago, back when they were actually using 35mm print. We used to use this as a break and it was a full t-shirt back then. Now, as you can see, it's just rags. I'm sure it's going to do the job anyway, so let's crank this up and see how fast we can go.
As we get down to the end, we use your little brake and we slowly slow it down. Once the spool's finished, I'm going to have to make a cut in the film. I'm going to cut off the last little bit of film, which is actually just scrap film, again, with information showing the projectionist exactly what you're dealing with. We use this lovely contraption here called a splicer. It has a little blade here where I can cut film. It's got some special kineton. It's basically just sticky tape, but it's special sticky tape. I can put film in here and be able to clamp it together. And I can join two spools together this way. Okay, you can see here, this is the last bits of frame. But hold on to the light there, you might be able to see the difference. The way it works is we cut the film right here, leaving one frame line, one frame exposed, and we join the next lot of film up to here. You can see also there's a soundtrack running down the side here. These lines code for the film. This is basically what the projector reads. There's our dogs. You can see there it says Reservoir Dogs. It's the head of the picture. Again, this is all just scrap film information for the projectionist. This, of course, is 24 frames per second. This is the countdown for the original style of projection that most people might have seen from Fight Club. Tyler Durden is a projectionist and he explains how it works. But he explains the older method where you have two projectors and you play the first ball in one projector and then you have to switch over to the next one looking for these cigarette burns, as he called them.
In the industry, we call them cigarette burns.
Basically, what you're seeing here is the mark when a projectionist needs to switch projectors. There are four little holes right before the reel runs out. By the time the end of the film goes through the projector, it's already switched to the other one, running perfectly, and the audience has no idea what's happened. Okay, so now I have successfully made the entire print. The only problem now is that this is the end of the film and I need it to be the beginning of the film. So I'm going to rewind this print. I haven't used this in quite some time, so usually it's something nice like this to cap it off. But the Babylon have seemed to have made their own version of it. We get an empty one to put on the top. By the end of this entire film will go through these rollers and will end up the top with the beginning of the film ready to go into the projector and start the movie.
Cada formato de proyección yo veo conveniente ajustar la luz el foco a la pantalla, que la luz quede uniforme a la pantalla y con el máximo de luz posible que se pueda, vaya, sin llegar a límites tampoco muy de demasiada luz, porque evidentemente se puede quemar la película, ¿no?
Alright, so this is Reservoir Dogs. You've got a 35mm print. I'm about to thread it through the projector. Just in time for tonight's screening in about 30 minutes time.
Said, doctor, ain't there nothing I can take? I said, doctor, to relieve his bellyache. I said, doctor, ain't there nothing I can take? I said, doctor, to relieve his bellyache. Now let me get this straight. Put the lime in the coconut, you drank and bowled up. Put the lime in the coconut, you drank and